Hello students, welcome back to my channel Botany for NEET. Let us solve a match the following type question asked in the recent NEET 2024 exam. First let me read the question. List 1, citric acid cycle, glycolysis, electron transport system, proton gradient, cytoplasm, mitochondrial matrix, intermembrane space of mitochondria, inner mitochondrial membrane. So basically they are asking you the site where all these processes occur. Okay. So, glycolysis is also known as EMP pathway, which is Emden-Meyerhof-Parnas pathway. Okay, and during this glycolysis, we know that six carbon compound glucose gets converted into a three carbon compound, two molecules of three carbon compound, that is pyruvate, with generation of two molecules of ATP. And this process, glycolysis, occurs in cytoplasm. Okay. Next one is citric acid cycle. Citric acid cycle is also known as Krebs cycle, or it is also known as tricarboxylic acid cycle. And during this process, there will be generation of reducing powers like NADH and GTP, which are later used for ATP generation. Okay. And this citric acid cycle takes place in the mitochondrial matrix of mitochondria. Next is electron transport system, ETC. Electron transport system occurs in inner mitochondrial membrane. Why are we saying here inner mitochondrial membrane? That is because mitochondria is a double membrane bound organelle. It has an outer membrane as well as inner membrane, but the inner membrane has foldings known as cristae. Okay, so basically this is your matrix and you have the inner membrane, this is your outer membrane, this is your inner membrane. What is this intermitochondrial membrane space? Okay, mitochondrial membrane space between the inner membrane and outer membrane, this is your intermitochondrial membrane space and this is your matrix. Okay, so glycolysis occurs in cytoplasm, citric acid cycle or Krebs cycle occurs in the matrix of mitochondria, electron transport system occurs in the inner mitochondrial membrane, proton gradient. Now what is this proton gradient? So basically if we magnify the membranes, two membranes of the mitochondria, you have the outer membrane, outer mitochondrial membrane and inner mitochondrial membrane. So what actually happens is protons get pumped out from the matrix. Protons start getting pumped out into the mitochondrial membrane space. Okay. So there will be more protons here. Proton molecules here. Okay. Because they are being pumped out. So the movement of protons is occurring from matrix into the inner intermitochondrial membrane space. So there is proton gradient generated in the intermembrane space of mitochondria. Okay, during this electron transport chain, during ETC, what actually happens? Electrons start moving from one complex to other complex. During this, what finally happens is the protons get pumped out from the matrix into the intermitochondrial membrane space, generating a gradient. What is gradient meaning? Gradient means difference. Okay. So what actually happens is number of protons will be more in the intermembrane space than in the matrix. Now the concentration of protons is less here while it is more in the intermembrane space. So there is proton gradient generated. Is it clear? So citric acid cycle takes place in the mitochondrial matrix. Glycolysis occurs in the cytoplasm. Electron transport system occurs in the inner mitochondrial membrane. And proton gradient occurs in the intermembrane space of mitochondria. But one thing you need to remember here, in case of bacteria or prokaryotes, okay, where there is no development of nucleus, prokaryotes, that means no development, nucleus is not yet generated in these organisms, therefore they are called prokaryotes, okay. Now in prokaryotes, they do not have any membrane bound organelles, okay. But we know that mitochondria is a membrane bound organelle, and how many membranes it is having? Two membranes. So in prokaryotes, I'm saying that they do not have any membrane bound organelles. Okay. Then where do this process occur? Citric acid cycle and electron transport system. So remember that in whether it is prokaryote or eukaryote, glycolysis occurs in the cytoplasm. And in case of prokaryote, citric acid cycle also occurs in the cytoplasm only. Okay. Whereas in eukaryotes, it takes place in the mitochondrial matrix. And electron transport system takes place in the inner mitochondrial membrane in case of eukaryotes. Whereas in prokaryotes, it takes place in the plasma membrane, which is the outer boundary of the cell. Okay. So for easy understanding, let me write it in this way. We know we have three processes, that is glycolysis, Krebs cycle or citric acid cycle, and you have electron transport system. You have prokaryotes like your bacteria and eukaryotes like humans. Okay. Now the site where glycolysis happens is cytoplasm. Okay, both in prokaryotes as well as in eukaryotes. Krebs cycle in prokaryotes, it takes place in the cytoplasm itself. Why? Because they don't have any mitochondria, any membrane-bound organ. Whereas in eukaryotes, it takes place in the matrix of mitochondria, not in the membranes. Okay, in the matrix. While electron transport chain occurs in the plasma membrane, which is the outer boundary of the cell. In eukaryotes, it takes place in the inner membrane of mitochondria. Not in the outer membrane, please be very clear, in the inner membrane of the mitochondria. So, I'm sorry. Please be clear with this. The Krebs cycle as well as glycolysis occur in the cytoplasm only in prokaryotes, whereas electron transport chain takes place in the plasma membrane. So, the sites are different. Be clear, it is not the same site both in prokaryotes as well as eukaryotes. As prokaryotes do not have membrane bound organelles, therefore Krebs cycle occurs in cytoplasm while electron transport chain takes place in the plasma membrane. Whereas in eukaryotes, glycolysis occurs in cytoplasm, Krebs cycle occurs in the matrix of mitochondria, and electron transport chain takes place in the inner membrane of mitochondria. Okay. I hope the answer or the solution for this question is clear. If you have any doubts, please feel free to comment it down below. If you like this content, please share it with your friends. Happy learning. Bye-bye.